Continuing my videos about the Mirror of Erised with a part 3. You guys prefer the video about the Marauders, but don't worry, I'll be doing all the other choices in the future videos. Now let's discuss what would the Marauders see in the Mirror of Erised. Before we get started, 97% of my viewers aren't subscribed, so please do me a favor and subscribe, it would be very much appreciated. Now let's get into the video. Let's start with James Potter. James was born to Flemings and Euphemia Potter. Having been conceived so late in his parents' lives, it was no surprise that he grew up to be proud, arrogant, and boastful. Flemings and Euphemia had quite given up hope of a son or daughter, when to their shock and surprise, Euphemia found that she was pregnant and their beloved boy, James, was born. So if James before the age of 11 have looked into the Mirror of Erised, he wouldn't see much, as he was so loved and taken care of by his parents. They gave him anything he needed, and if there is something he wanted so bad, it would be having a younger brother or sister, as James was the only son of the Potters. At the age of 11, James started attending Hogwarts, where he befriended fellow Gryffindors Sirius, Remus, and Peter. They together formed a small gang, known only to themselves as the Marauders. James proved to be clever students, he even became chaser for his house Quidditch team. So if James would have looked into the mirror in the time, he would have seen nothing but he and his friends, viewed as the rock stars of Hogwarts, together roaming the grounds as animals, exploring every nook and cranny of Hogwarts, as well as using the greatest invention, the Marauder's Map. Recorded all their favorite secret passages and blazed the trail for troublemakers. He would also see himself as a professional Quidditch player, flying in the middle of the packed Quidditch stadium where everyone is cheering for him. Years later, James and Snape had a strong rivalry throughout this time at Hogwarts. However, the hatred between the two became bigger when one girl, Lily Evans, entered the subject. Snape had a crush on her without her knowing. Lily was among those who weren't so impressed of James, considering him arrogant and obnoxious. One day, Snape called Lily filthy little mudblood. That was the end of the friendship between the two. James, who had already developed a crush on Lily, started chasing after her. So if James would have looked into the Mirror of Erised in his last year at Hogwarts, he would have seen himself and Lily in a relationship and dating. He would have seen himself and Lily as prefect, walking in Hogwarts grounds and being together all the time. Although he's still holding a hatred towards Snape and would love to see himself torturing him again, I believe that James had matured to the point that he loses the interest of jinxing Snape just for Lily's sake. James' desire did indeed come true, as he and Lily eventually got married at the age of 18. 2 years later, the couple became parents to Harry James Potter. The family was later in grave danger as their son Harry became a target of Lord Voldemort. The family went into hiding in their house in Godric's Hollow. So if James somehow have looked into the mirror, he would have seen nothing but his family being safe and alive, and most importantly, the dark wizard Voldemort to be finished and gone. He would also see his son Harry growing up in front of his eyes, taking him to Hogwarts in his first year, and Lily being there with him. Unfortunately, none of this happened, as the family were betrayed. Voldemort found him and murdered both him and Lily, leaving their son alive as Voldemort couldn't kill him. Sirius Black. Sirius clearly had a miserable childhood, the only Gryffindor in a family full of Slytherins, being brought up in a pure-blood obsessed household. But Sirius kept up a constant resistance. Sirius actively rejected his family beliefs and expectations, and that took a lot of courage. Sirius didn't even share a close relationship with his younger brother Regulus, calling him a better son than himself. So before the age of 11, if Sirius would have looked into the mirror, he would have seen love showered upon him by his whole pure-blood loving family. He would have been accepted by his family, a family that isn't obsessed so much with pure blood heritage. Maybe he would also desire and craft friendship, actual friends to hang out with and have fun. Once Sirius went to the school, he had friends. He had overthrown his parents and was sorted into Gryffindor. Although his parents hated him more than ever, he didn't care much about it during that time. Thus he finally ran away from home at age of 16 to live with his best friend James. Everything was good until his friend's death, Lily and James. flames and also being sent to Azkaban for life imprisonment. Those Azkaban years must be the worst in Sirius' life. So if Sirius looked into the mirror, he would see himself innocent and Peter being captured and sent to Azkaban instead. He would see himself with his friends, Lily and James once again, happy and smiling because their death was so devastated to him. But after seeing Peter and realizing that he was alive and hiding in Hogwarts, Sirius would see nothing but him avenging his friend's death. He would see himself focusing on escaping past the Dementors and tracking Pettigrew all the way to Hogwarts. But after escaping and the start of the Second Wizarding War, Sirius would see himself trying to protect Harry, his godson, and live with him after everything ends. He would also want Voldemort to be gone and finished. He fought and risked his own life to make this happen. But the fact that his final moments were spent actively defending his godson was at least a fitting death for Sirius. Remus Lupin. Lupin's situation was different than of the others. At the age of 5, he was attacked by Greyback and became infected with lycanthropy. Thus, he became a werewolf himself. His parents thought that his affliction would prevent him from attending in school. So Lupin's greatest wish in his childhood is seeing himself as a normal human with nothing wrong with him, or at least his parents finding a cure for his condition. However, Albus Dumbledore allowed Remus to attend Hogwarts. Remus was brought to the Shrieking Shack once a month for his transformation. This transformation was really painful and scary, which made Remus hate it. Also, his Bogart was a full moon, which Remus feared the most. So if Remus during his 7 years at Hogwarts would have looked into the mirror, he would have always been the same thing. He and his friends under the full moon were remaining fully human and not transforming because he hated being a werewolf and felt guilty all the time for being something he had no control over. Lupin's condition even made his life more difficult after school. He couldn't get a consistent job because of his lycanthropy, and he was left lonely and unhappy. So if Remus would have taken a look now, he would have seen he and his friends back again together, as two of his three best friends are dead and one imprisoned. He would hope to see himself getting a well-paying job instead of the ones that far below his level of ability. He would have seen himself able to buy the Wolfsbane potion for himself, which was very expensive. And above all, he would never stop seeing himself under the full moon and transformed. Later, when he and Tonks get married during the Second Wizarding War, Lupin would see nothing but a world where Voldemort is gone and finished. He, Tonks, and his son Tiddy all happy and healthy. And while Tonks became pregnant, his greatest desire would be finding out that Tiddy was a normal baby and not a werewolf. However, sadly, Remus and Tonks died in the battle while fighting to make a better world for their son. Fortunately, Harry eventually won the war and became godfather of Tiddy, proving that Remus' son will live a happier life in safe hands. Peter Pettigrew. Nothing is really known about Peter's childhood, so we can't decide what he desired the most back then. Peter was described as a stupid, foolish boy who hero worshipped Sirius and James. He was also stated by McGonagall as a less than average student. So if Peter would have looked into the mirror, he would have seen himself with his popular and talented friends, being beside his clever friends. So people can suggest that he's a clever one as well. Peter wasn't even a brave person. He took part in the bullying of Severus Snape, but he would have dared to bully Snape without his friends protecting him. Thus, Peter would keep seeing his brave friends around him to protect him and make him look special by the most of the school. But after a couple years, everything changed. While Peter began working as a spy for Voldemort, he didn't betray the Potters to Voldemort, which led to their death. However, that night were also the night where Voldemort met his downfall. Peter, having no choice, turned himself into his rat form and fled. Then he became the Weasley's family pet. So if Peter would have looked into the mirror during this time, he would have seen himself living with the Weasleys in peace for years, and them not finding out who he actually was. He didn't feel bad about Voldemort being gone. He instead felt free from both his master wrath and the Death Eaters who were searching for him. He also didn't care that his best friend James had died, and he was the reason behind it. The happy and peaceful life didn't last for too long, as in 1993, Sirius managed to reveal Peter's true identity in front of his older friend Remus. But before sending Peter to the Dementors in exchange for Sirius' freedom, Peter was able to escape from them using his Animagus form. Peter was able to help Voldemort gain his Barry back so that the Second Wizarding War began. So if Peter would have looked into the mirror now, he would have seen himself in Voldemort's side once again, living under under his master's power. Cause Peter doesn't care about anyone, he just seeks brave, powerful people. And Voldemort was the darkest wizard of all time by then. Although he was considered nothing more than a servant, Peter would be happy seeing himself in Voldemort's sight. But one thing that changed everything was Peter's interest in death. At Malfoy Manor, when Harry reminded him that he owed him a life debt, Peter hesitated. It was a brave moment of mercy that caused his silver hand to strangle him and kill him, thus proving that Peter probably felt a bit pity for his friends that died because of him, and also regretted everything he had done in the past.